Welcome to Dungeons & Brackets. 64 monsters and level 1 characters from across the United States will compete to claim the crown of March Madness. We've taken the mascots for every team in the NCAA tournament and found their creature equivalents in the Dungeons & Dragons Monster Manual 5th Edition, pitting them against one another using the sacred rules of D&D combat. We'll find the true champion and crown them the winner of Dungeons & Brackets. Up first, we have Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers and New Orleans Privateers. Roll initiative.
All right, let's do this. All right.
Choose your die.
And.
Oh!
That's a 3 on my
three
initiative.
3 for the Mountaineers.
21.
21 for the Privateers. The Privateers go first.
All right, well, I will start with a scimitar attack.
The Privateers have an AC of 15 and 20 hit points.
That is plus 6, 20.
Well, the Mountaineers have an armor class of 13 and 12 hit points, so that hits.
All right.
Let's do this. Come on.
Roll damage.
Bring it.
1d6.
You can't kill me.
6 plus 3 is 9.
Ooh. A mighty blow.
And I have multi-attack, so let's take another...
Another
swing. That is a 14.
14? That's
no.
Gonna hit. That's gonna hit.
Another 9 damage.
Well, that's what happens when you're seated 16. Mount St. Mary's Mountaineers didn't stand a chance. Next up, we have the Villanova Wildcats facing the winner of the first 4, the New Orleans Privateers. Which is not how it went down today in the real world. All right, roll initiative.
12 plus 3, 15.
5.
The Privateers go first.
All right, let's see if I can do this again. Gonna hit him with my scimitar. It's a 19 plus 5.
That hits. The Villanova Wildcats have an armor class of 12 and 13 hit points.
4 plus 3 is 7.
7 is a mighty blow.
Multi-attack and a swing with a scimitar again.
Something tells me these Privateers are going to go far.
11 plus 5, 16.
That also hits.
Ooh, 4.
Oh, 4 total. All right, the Wildcats stay alive. Wildcats, your turn.
The Wildcat is going to pounce. He's going to try to anyway.
Oh, okay.
You can try.
So here we go. It's an 8 plus 4, 12.
Does not hit me.
A 12 does not hit.
It's stating.
The Privateers dodges the Wildcat. Privateer.
All right. Swinging at it again.
Unfortunate.
13?
A 13 hits.
Built for slaughtering. That is 7 points of damage.
And the Wildcat's head explodes! Privateers are the winner. Villanova's out in the first round. That is non. I think people at Villanova winning the whole brackets.
Get yourself a stronger mascot.
Yeah, get a better mascot. Up next, we have Wisconsin University's Bucky the Badger against the Virginia Tech Hokie Bird. Bucky has an armor class of 10 and 13 hit points. The Hokie Bird has an armor class of 11 and 27 hit points.
Mm-hmm.
Roll initiative.
The Hokie Bird rolls 17.
17.
Plus 1 for an 18, I'm sorry.
18.
Bucky rolls a 2 plus...
I don't think it's plus 16. The Hokie Bird goes first.
The Hokie Bird goes 20 feet up into the air before swooping in for a bite.
Ooh.
It's a 15 plus 3 is 18.
Scrawl!
That hits.
It's 1d4 plus 1, giving us 3.
3! A mighty blow on the Bucky the Badger.
So the hoagie bird is a cockatrice, so it's a poisoned bite, so you're going to need to do a DC 11 constitution saving throw or be magically petrified.
Alright, here we go. Let's see, come on, Bucky. Come on, buddy. That's a nat 20.
Oh, save. Bucky saves. And it's Bucky's turn.
Bucky is not too happy about being bit. Bucky's gonna come back with his own bite attack. And he's going to roll a 17 plus 3 for a roll of 20.
That hits.
Scrawl. And that bite is a d6 plus 1. That is 3 damage. But Bucky has multi-attack. Mm. He can make one bite attack and a one claw attack.
Mm-hmm.
So Bucky is also going to swipe. 16 plus 3 is a 19. And that...
Roll damage.
...is 2d4.
Ooh, a mighty blow.
This is garbage.
That is 5 plus 1. That is 6 damage.
Mmm. Mm-hmm. 6 damage on the Hokey Bird. Mm-hmm.
The Hokey Bird has one thing he can do. But he's going to do it well, because what he's going to do is bite you again. That's a 5 plus 3 is an 8.
That's going to miss.
Okay, he's going to go 40 feet straight up in the air and just hover.
Very clever. But the Hoagie Bird used his action to attack, not use disengage. Therefore, the Badger gets an attack of opportunity on the Hoagie Bird before moving out of melee range.
And he's going to take a big old bite. And it's going to miss at a 2.
The Hokey Bird flies 40 feet in the air and hovers above the Badger. What can the Badger do?
Well, unfortunately, Badgers cannot go 40 feet up in the air. However, Badgers do have the ability to burrow 10 feet into the ground, which is exactly what Bucky is going to do, and wait for this bird to come back down and try do some.
Okay.
Oh my.
The Hokey Bird flies back down and tries diplomacy. Now, the Hokey... You're 10 feet underground?
10 feet underground.
I don't have anything I can do to you. Yeah, I'm gonna relieve myself into the ground right at your hole.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Make a constitution saving throw.
Christ. That's a 6 plus 2 is an 8.
Not very
that
good.
That fails. you're now poisoned.
No!
You have disadvantage on attack rolls and ability checks.
That's oh, right, God. You do. From my poisoned stew.
Yep.
That means I have to
but
roll.
It is now the Badger's turn.
Oh.
Okay, he's going to come back up out of the ground, covered in feces, and try to take a swing at you with his claws. Here we go. First roll is a 14 plus 3 is a 17,
that
but the
hit.
Second roll... is a 6 plus 3, which is a 9.
Oh, that's not gonna hit.
Oh, multi-attack hopefully will help with this because he can make a bite now.
Yeah, go for
so
it.
So the first roll is a 13 plus 3, which is a 16.
That would hit.
And the second roll is a 2.
Ooh,
plus,
no.
Which is a 5.
Shit-covered Bucky can't land a hit.
And since he used his movement, now he's just out in the open covered in shit and
that's pissed. Correct.
Hokey Bird's turn.
Hokey Bird's turn. Hokey Bird goes in for a closed mouth bite. That's...
a peck.
A peck. 18 plus 3, that's 21.
That's gonna hit.
That's gonna hit.
Oh, God.
1d4 plus 1. 2.
2 damage.
And 40 feet straight up in the air.
Oh, attack of opportunity.
Go
okay.
for it.
Okay, disadvantage. That's a critical botch.
Oh.
Which is guaranteed since I don't have
yep.
to roll.
You just miss.
Okay. Ow, the smells. Oh, God.
Okay, now what are you going to do, Bucky the Badger?
Bucky can't do anything except burrow back down into the ground.
You want to do that?
I don't think so.
Make another constitution saving throw.
Very fair. That's a 15.
All right, you're no longer poisoned.
17?
Okay.
No longer poisoned.
Okay, Bucky is going to ready an action.
Okay.
He's going to stand back and ready a bite for whenever the Hokey Bird gets in range.
All right, fair enough.
The Hokey Bird's bowels are empty, so I'm afraid he's just gonna have to swoop on in and bite. That's a 12 plus 3 is a 15.
That'll hit.
It'll hit!
Roll damage.
3.
Oh, God.
3 damage.
But I have, and I have to make
this
a,
bird sucks.
I have to make the petrification saving throw. That's a nat 20.
Wow.
Whew.
Bucky Badger don't give a fuck.
Is, damn it.
Bucky's readied bite is now about to unleash. And that is a crit!
Oh, that...
Garbage.
Bucky the Badger rolled a natural 20, which is a critical roll. Roll damage.
Let's do this. 1d6 plus 1, that's a 5, plus 1 is 6. How do we calculate the critical damage?
I'm gonna double it.
12 damage.
I'm gonna bite him right back. 13 plus 3 is 16.
That's gonna hit.
How's he looking?
Bucky the Badger has 5 hit points. The Virginia Tech Hokiebird has 6 hit points.
So this is a pretty important roll. If this runs on a 4, I beat you.
Yes.
Oh, in the box.
Sorry, okay. Ow! 3.
Oh.
Let's see what happens.
Live to fight another day.
Bucky the Badger has 1 hit point and must make a constitution saving throw against paralysis.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, that's right.
Here we go, here we go. 14!
That saves.
Ah, here we go. Well, he's coming back with the claws here. That is not going to hit. That's a 3 plus 3 is a 6.
That's a miss.
However, he has multi-attack with his bite, so he's going to come back with the... And that's a 19 plus 3.
That hits. Roll damage.
Very much. That is a d6 plus 1. That's 5 damage total.
Total.
4 plus 1.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bucky the Badger has 1 hit point. The Virginia Tech Hokiebird has 1 hit point.
That's right. He rears back.
It's the Hokiebird's turn. In the box, please. In the box.
Give me the D20. I'm all thumbs.
Right here.
Oh,
it's right there.
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay. I'm going to bite him.
Yes!
What'd you roll? A 9.
A 9 misses.
Yes!
Would you like to do anything else?
I don't want
to
risk the attack of opportunity. I'm going to stay in this telephone booth and duke it out.
Let's do this! Let's
go. All right, Bucky.
You've got nothing.
Bucky's bite has been working a lot better for him than his claws, so Bucky's going to take a big old chomper with his big old front teeth. That's a 13 plus 3 is a 16.
That hits.
And a full damage, 7d.
The University of Wisconsin, Bucky the Badger, is the most unlikely winner against the Virginia Tech Hokiebird.
That was an excellent
battle.
Up next, we have the University of Virginia Cavaliers.
Wahoo wah!
And the University of North Carolina at Wilmington.
Sammy, they're the Seahawks.
Sammy Seahawk.
There it is.
I'm gonna leave it. The Cavaliers have an armor class of 13 and 11 hit points. The UNC Wilmington Seahawks have an armor class of 13 and 1 hit point.
Only need one.
Roll for initiative.
You know what? No, I'm using them UVA, that UVA orange.
Okay, I'll do these like seafoam blue ones then.
That's an excellent choice for them. The Virginia Cavaliers roll a critical botch, a 1. So that is a 1 plus 2 is a 3.
It's not a botch in initiative.
Oh, right, sorry.
I rolled 2 plus 3, it's 5.
So right. The Hawks go first.
Yeah. The Hawks go first.
All right. So the Hawk's gonna, he flies up into the air 30 feet and then dives down with his talons. That's a 4 plus 5, 9.
That misses. The Seahawk swoops in, but misses the Cavalier.
The Cavalier sees this Seahawk attempting to encroach in his territory.
Right in your face.
Right in his face. And the Cavalier chooses to summon his mighty steed.
One question for you. What is the casting time on Fine Steed?
The casting time is... Oh, geez. Yeah, never mind. Casting time's 10 minutes.
All right. The University of Virginia Cavalier begins to wave his hands in a magical motion, summoning a magical steed.
Can I interrupt that in another turn and try an action, or do I have to continue doing that?
Depends on how much you want that horse.
All right. All right. Never mind.
First rule in D&D, don't split the party. Second rule in D&D, thoroughly read your spells. Seahawks.
All right, I'm gonna scratch at him with my talons again. All right, that's better. That's 11 plus 5.
Nice. 16. That's gonna hit.
All right.
It's a D4 minus 1.
All right, well, that's 1 damage.
All right.
Cavalier suddenly realizes that he's wasting tremendous amount of time trying to summon a steed that takes 100 rounds to summon in battle. So the Cavalier is going to cancel his spell and draw his mighty rapier and stab at thee.
I don't know if any rapiers are really mighty.
7 plus 1, that is an 8.
That misses.
Not gonna hit.
Rapiers are not effective against hawks, apparently.
All right, gonna keep trying with those talons. That is a 1, natural 1.
Yes. I'm afraid that Sammy Seahawk, with a critical botch, forgot that earlier in the day he ate a tablet of Alka-Seltzer, and he explodes.
Ah, come on!
Dying by 1 hit point.
I don't believe that.
You lost 1 hit point.
I don't believe that.
I mean, otherwise you just would have lost, you know, done a little damage to yourself,
well, maybe I like fall and I'm like prone or something.
Okay, he falls and he's prone, and then you step on him.
The Virginia Cavalier stands over Sammy Seahawk, looks down at him, raises his boot and says, wahoo wah, and just steps on his head.
Winner. For our next matchup, we have Albert the Gator from the University of Florida against Bucky the Pirate from Eastern Tennessee State University.
Yar.
Pirates and gators are like, that's a classic matchup.
It is. It's like Captain Hook and the gator.
They've been fighting for centuries.
Roll initiative.
Plus nothing. That's going to be a 13.
A 13 for the gator.
That is a 5 in total.
5 for Bucky. Albert the Gator goes first.
Albert the Gator moves within range and throws him a bite. That is a 3 plus 4 is 7.
That misses.
Bucky. I guess all I can ever be is a pirate, so gonna go with that scimitar again. Different school,
a scimitar. Still a pirate.
What is that, an 8 plus 5 is a 13.
That's gonna hit. Roll damage.
All right, a d6. That's 6 plus 3 is 9.
9, a mighty blow.
Ouch. Yeah,
got myself a multi-attack, so let's go for number 2. That is another 8 plus 5 is 13.
That will also hit.
Let's see. Another 6.
Albert the Gator has 1 hit point left.
Rolling hot.
This gator from Florida doesn't go down easy. And he does a little 19 plus 4 for a 23 bite.
Ooh, that will hit.
Yeah. So damage is going to be 1d10 plus 2. That's 6.
Nice. So Albert the Gator bites you and attempts to grapple you with his gaping maw. So you must beat a DC 12?
Correct.
Athletics or acrobatics saving throw.
Then I'm going to do dex because for some reason it's plus 5. Oh, that's why. All right, yes.
Because he's a pirate.
Yeah.
He's a pirate.
So that is a... Is that a 9?
Yes, it is.
14 in total.
That'll save. You're cut, pirate. But you're not caught. And it's your turn.
All right, let's finish off this gator. That not going to hit with a 2.
No, he's not.
Okay. But I got multi-attack, so let's swing at him again. A 12 plus... 5. It's 17.
That's going to hit.
Ugh.
Roll. You don't even need to roll damage.
Let's just see if I get overkill. And that's 7 damage.
You turned me into a purse.
I love leather.
Up next, we have the Rhode Island Friars with an armor class of 13 and 14 hit points, and the University of Southern California Trojans with an armor class of 19 because of the shield. And 12 hit points.
Do you think this is representative of USC's actual defense?
Not this year.
Okay.
Roll initiative.
Hit me.
Oh, I had an 8 before you hit mine. So there's an 8 plus nothing.
16.
And 16, the Trojans go first.
We certainly do. And...
Do you have weapons?
I do.
Okay.
Sorry. I was just seeing if he does anything other than use a short sword. He doesn't. So,
all right.
The USC Trojan will use a short sword. 17 plus 5 is a 23.
That will hit.
So, damage. Let's do 1d6 plus 3. 4 plus 3, that's 7.
7!
It's half my hit
points. A mighty
points.
Blow to the Friars.
Let's see what
right,
this Friar
Friars,
can do.
Your turn.
All right. I am going to cast Sanctuary.
The Friars have cast Sanctuary. He wards a creature within range against attack until the spell ends. Any creature who targets the warded creature with an attack or a harmful spell must first make a wisdom saving throw. On a failed save, the creature must choose a new target or lose the attack.
So that was my bonus action. So with my action, I am going to cast Guiding Bolt.
Ooh.
So I will roll a ranged spell attack. Whoops, I missed the box.
In the box.
All right, that's a 12 plus 5.
But it's minus 5 for missing the box the first time.
A 12 plus 5 is a 17. That doesn't hit.
So strong. Right. I'm so strong.
But the Friar casts Sanctuary. You must make Sanctuary. A wisdom saving throw, beating 13 in right. order to attack.
I got plus 1 to wisdom saves. 3.
I think you fail.
A little low.
Ouch. You lose your attack.
I lose my attack.
Yep.
Yes.
I choose to do nothing.
Very well. Friar's turn.
I'm gonna try that guiding bolt again.
Okay.
With my other... Oh wait, no, I can't. That was both of my slots. Both of my first level slots.
Snap. You better stick them with the pointy end.
Yeah, that is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use my mace.
Okay.
All right, that's a 16 plus 2. 18?
Oh, that misses. Trojans.
All right, the Trojan goes in with his short sword above his head, brings it down.
Wait, first, wisdom saving throw.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
All right, wisdom save. 18.
That saves.
Short sword, 14 plus 5 is 19.
That hits.
1d6. 6 plus 3.
Ooh! And the Friars are felled.
Ha!
Up next, we have the other winner of our first four. The University of Southern California Trojans against the Southern Methodist University Peruna the Mustang. It's a desolate battlefield. There are bodies strewn everywhere, corpses and gristle, the stench of blood. The Trojan scans for any of his fallen brethren. Maybe one still draws breath. And out of the fog comes an enemy warhorse. Peruna, the Mustang.
Does the horse look friendly? Like, maybe I can ride it and get out of here.
Nay.
In that case, I'll try to stab it with my short sword. And that is a 4 plus 6, but it's not gonna.
Ooh,
still not as close.
No, it's not gonna hit.
You have a plus 6?
I don't. The Trojan does.
That's crazy.
But remember, an intelligence of minus 1.
Yeah, well, you know, they fell for that whole horse thing.
They also bet all their eggs on Matt Leinart for 2 years in a row.
So I'm going to rear up and try to hit this Trojan with my hooves.
Holy shit!
All right, that's an 18 plus 6.
That's gonna hit.
Yes. And this is 2d6 plus 4 bludgeoning.
Whoa.
Yes, 2 sixes.
Christ.
Plus 4.
Peruna the
Warhorse
rears its hooves and tramples the USC Trojan to death.
16 damage.
Winner,
yes.
SMU. All right.
What an upset.
In our next matchup, we have the Baylor Bears against the New Mexico State Aggies.
Now, since Aggie is short for agricultural, because they're an agricultural school, we had to go with their mascot instead of their name. And their mascot happens to be a cowboy named Pistol Pete. So we made a level one ranger and gave him a gun. We gave him a six-shot gun and 12 bullets.
Pistol Pete is tending to his cattle outside of Albuquerque.
Get along there, boys. Come on, let's go.
Wherever New Mexico State is. I don't know.
New Mexico, by and large, is very much the same no matter where you are in the state.
Sure.
So, very good rustling.
And he sees on the horizon a mighty bear who's wandered all the way from Waco, Texas. Roll initiative.
Is that a bear? No bear's gonna be getting any of my cattle.
Maybe.
That is a 15.
A 15 for the bear?
Yes.
It's gonna roll these green dice. That is a 9 plus 3 is a 12.
12. The bear goes first.
Oh boy.
You know, bears have keen smell. So I think he probably smells you.
Definitely.
And,
he smells the cattle.
Well, he could be distracted by the smell of all the cattle.
No, he's got keen smell. that is a 3. Plus, nothing.
That misses.
And he's going to do his multi-attack. That is,
six.
6 plus 5.
That also misses.
Pistol Pete jumps back, avoiding narrowly the claws and bite of this great brown bear. Draws his revolver and says, "You'll not be taking none of my cattle!" And takes a big old shot. And, that is a 4 plus 5. That is a 9.
That also misses.
So, this bear
tarnation
does a matrix dodge as the bullets fly over and circles around to, pummel you with his, face in the form of a bite and claws.
I'm gonna pummel you with my face.
Yes. This is an 8 plus 0.
That misses.
And, claws. We got 15 plus, 5. That's a 20.
That hits.
Let's roll some damage. That's a 7 plus 4 slashing damage to Pistol Pete.
11. That is just enough.
My cattle!
Pistol Pete is eviscerated by the Baylor Bear, who then enjoys all of Pistol Pete's cattle. Up next, we have South Carolina University Gamecocks versus the Marquette Golden Eagle.
Look at me not even taking that bait. Standing in for the South Carolina Gamecock, we've got a Cockatrice.
A Cockatrice, nice. And for the Golden Eagle?
Since Golden Eagles are the biggest of all the eagles, we made them a giant eagle.
Nice. Marquette, the Golden Eagle, is flying along through some nice clouds, and off in the distance he sees an enemy fighter at 11 o'clock. The South Carolina Gamecock approaches quickly in his territory.
Get out of my territory. Am I still going second now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's Marquette's...
I think that was his action, though. So
Marquette's
I'm just
turn.
He's going to attack him with his beak. That's an 18 plus 5. So
that
23.
Hits. Oh, that hits.
I have a beak of my own.
That's going to be a D6 plus 3 damage. So that's 7 damage.
Ooh, 7 damage.
Yes, sir.
He kisses you so hard. Your turn.
I'm not finished.
He's not done.
Oh!
He's got talents as well.
Ooh!
That is a 14 plus 5.
That also hits.
And it's going to be a 2d6 plus 3 slashing damage. That is 11 plus 3,
14. Wow! Mighty blows from Marquette on the Gamecock.
The South Carolina Gamecock rears back and draws from a deep well of resentment for having the word cock in its name before biting you for 16.
16 hits.
You're gonna have to succeed on a DC 11 Constitution saving throw, or be magically petrified after I do some damage here.
Ooh.
1d4 plus one on the damage, and it is five.
Five damage.
Full damage. Right.
10 plus 1.
Ooh! Marquette the Golden Eagle saves on a magical petrification.
Everyone says I'm petrifying.
And it's Marquette's turn.
That's a three.
A three will miss.
That's gonna miss.
Devastating.
But you have multi-attack.
I do, so I'm gonna try these talents now and give them a shot. And that's gonna be an 8 plus 5.
That will hit.
Excellent.
A 13 hits the game cack.
That's going to be another 2d6 plus 3 damage. That's 3 plus 3, 6 damage.
The Gamecock is torn apart.
This is garbage. This is all starting to feel.
Feathers fly in the air, and it plummets like a meteor, and dies.
And dies.
Winner, Marquette. Up next, we have the Duke Blue Devils against the Troy University Trojans. Cameron, what do we do for the Blue Devil?
So the Duke Blue Devil is based on a bearded devil in the Monster Manual, but with slightly less HP than he normally starts with.
Copy that. Duke goes first.
Okay, I'm going to first attack with my beard.
I wish I could do that.
That's a 7 plus 5.
That is going to miss.
How does one attack with a beard?
Yeah, okay. There you go.
Very, very menacing.
And right? I have multi-attack, so I can also attack with my glaive. But that's a 4 plus 5, so also not it.
That also misses.
Right.
Troy.
I got a sword, so I'm going to swing it.
Swing that sword.
That is a 19 plus Ooh. 5.
That hits.
It's a 1d6 plus 3 plus 2 because I'm dueling. So, plus 5. That is a 5 plus 5. Ooh. That's 10 damage.
It's half of my hit points.
Duke.
Oh, wait, hold on. Because I am a devil, I have damage resistance against cold, bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing from non-magical weapons that aren't silvered.
Ooh. In that case, it is 5 damage.
Ha!
This seems like a one-sided battle.
The Duke Blue Devil may be our overall number one seed.
Have you ever danced bracket. With the devil in the pale blue, in the pale moonlight?
Sadly, I
haven't.
Alright, I'm attacking my beard again. That's a 13 plus 5.
That hits.
Alright. 5 damage.
Alright.
And now I do an attack with my glaive. 13 plus 5, also 18.
That also hits.
D10 plus 3. 10 damage.
Oh.
I think that's it.
Just enough.
The Blue Devil summons all of his power of the infernal deaths and slays the Trojan.
No.
Winner, Duke.
Join us next time for round one of the West Bracket. Like, comment, subscribe, you know the drill.